Ciao everyone, it's Marcatino and this is how does a nearly 1,300 horsepower hypercar acceleration looks like.
That was 100 miles an hour there.
That's in miles per hour.
Yeah. This is the performance screen that we have. So here you can see the torque distribution on each wheel. You can see the longitudinal and lateral G, so the forces on the car, steering wheel angle, and the slip angle of the car. And you can see also the power distribution, or this is how much power we are using, and this is how much power we are regenerating back to the battery with the, either with the curse or with the braking or with one pedal drive. So we have four electric motors that are independent, two at the front, two at the rear, and since the motors are independent, we can control each wheel independently, whatever we want. We can control each motor 100 times a second, so the torque vectoring system is changing the torque on each motor and calculating how much torque you need on each motor. So then we have the energy screen. You can see how much power the powertrain is using or other systems. We have the battery screen, so you can see all the cells in the car, so the state of the cells. You can hear, you see on the thermal screen what's the temperature of motors, inverters, stuff like that. You can see with the temperatures of the coolant going in and out of the systems. We have our trips like a normal trip computer, and we have our stats. So this is quite nifty because you can see everything that's been happening with the car in the last 5 minutes, 30 minutes, stuff like that. So for example, if I want to see the speed, total power, or anything else, so we have a lot of data here, so slip angle, let's say, we open the graphs and we have 5 minutes, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, you know. You go to last 30 minutes, what has been happening, so you can see that we were driving, we were going like 120. You can overlay those graphs. You can see how you've been, what you've been doing, and also the car is sending all this data. So we're sending like 500 data packs over the 4G network to the cloud, and you can open this and watch it later on either your mobile phone or your desktop computer or anything else. So this is basically a big telemetry system. We can also, on the settings, see the three preset systems. So we have three preset modes. So we have range, sport, race, custom one, and custom two. For example, in the custom one, you can customize the drivetrain. So whatever is your preferences, you can have a car that's totally front-wheel drive, or a car that's totally rear-wheel drive, whatever you like, or 50-50, or whatever you like.
What's the recommended setup for driving this car?
Race. For me, it's race.
What about the torque distribution?
The torque distribution we keep at 100% both, because the torque vectoring is calculating how much torque you need.
Okay.
So the car will be perfectly neutral on 100%. If you want the car to be a little bit more tail happy, then you leave it. You know, you reduce the power in the front.
Yeah.
Or if you want the car to have an understeer car for some reason, you can, you know, reduce the power in the rear. You can also fiddle with the torque vectoring setup, with the gearbox, with the steering, with the throttle response, anything you like. And we also have the region with throttle that we mentioned. So when you're driving, you can have the one pedal drive. So when if you want to decelerate, you just leave the throttle off and you brake with the electric motors. Or if you want to accelerate, of course, you punch the throttle, that's it. We use the regenerative braking also on the brakes. So once you push the brakes for the first few inches of the travel, it uses the electric motors, and then it's the hydraulics kicks in when you press it all the way. So basically that's it. So all this has been made in Croatia. We do it all under one roof. So we have our design office, production, development, engineering, everything.
I'm seriously excited to see how does this car goes.
I'm curious because I see that there are the pedals vanishing though. Does it has the gears?
Yeah, we have two gears.
Okay.
The rear motors have the gearboxes.
Okay.
So we have two gears, so first and second. But we use the first gear for high acceleration, so a drag strip or racing or stuff like that.
Yeah.
Basically, you leave the car in second gear and drive it
all the time.
Yeah,
okay.
Because it goes from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in second gear in around 3 seconds. So that's, you know, that's more than enough for the road use. And it can hit 200 kilometers an hour in 6 seconds. Six seconds.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Okay. So we'll do a second gear acceleration here.
Okay.
Once it is levels up. And you can feel the difference between this car and the normal, like with a petrol engine car in the acceleration. We don't have to gear. We do the gear shift. Okay? You ready?
Yeah.
Let's go. That was 100 miles an hour.
That's in miles per hour.
Yeah. That's cool. Yes. You don't have to wait for the turbo. You don't have to wait.
Yeah, it's
for,
instant.
You know, yeah, it's just there. So
that's a cool thing about the electric.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
like now.
Yeah.
Each time you touch the accelerator, it just goes.
Yeah. Wow.
And you have 1,600 newton meters of torque every single time.
I have no words, really.
It's quite impressive.
Yeah, it is.
And since it's an electric car, you hear all the different noises. So for example, you don't have the noise of the motor or you don't have the gear shift, but you can hear the systems on the car, so pumps, ventilators, stuff like that. You can hear the suspension, but you can hear the tires. So for example, when you're driving really fast on the racetrack, when you start turning the wheel, you can hear when the tire will let go.
Yeah.
So maximum grip is not on zero slip. When the tire is rolling, it's on like 3 to 6% of slip, something like that. So you can hear that starts to slip, and when it starts to, you know, let go, the sound changes. Look, deers. I told you. We can sneak up on one of these.
Yeah, if we had a petrol engine car, they would have gone away.
Yeah.
They didn't hear us.
Yeah, it's a different kind of experience because your other senses come alive.
Yeah.
It's, you know, when you start driving, you can drive normally, it doesn't wear you down. There's no like big noise and stuff like that. It's a gentleman's car, but if you want it can be brutal.
Very brutal.
Really, yeah. It can be really, really, really sharp. And since you have the torque vectoring system, I can show you here on the screen. So the torque is changing constantly. So where we go to the corners, the torque is changing between the two wheels, left and right and front and rear. If we start to brake, we have negative torque. If we accelerate, you have positive torque. For example, when we're using the curse braking, you have the negative torque. We're braking with the electric motor. And just for you to see, so the torque vectoring is helping the car turn to the corner, so it's yaw control. And it really makes the car nimble, makes it almost like it has four-wheel steering. So, it really helps the car to turn into the corner. So you can be really precise, really fast, and you don't have to fight with the car. You can really use that as your advantage.
This is seriously impressive.
Yeah, you like it?
Yeah. I think I've never seen so much technology behind a car like this.
This is all done by us. So when we started, it was basically a showcase scenario of what we can do. And nowadays we are basically, you know, selling this technology to other companies. We're helping other companies become electric. We are trying to show everybody that electric doesn't have to be boring. This is the world's first all-electric hypercar. And it's, you know, it's proved that on the racetrack and off the racetrack, so this is only the beginning.
I think it's gonna be interesting in the future, because nowadays lots of manufacturers mm-hmm. are more interested towards creating electric cars, and I think someday they will create also hypercars to to be your rivals. So it's gonna be very interesting.
Definitely. The range of this car is 225 miles or in kilometers around 400. The thing is that we did a couple of comparisons with other supercars, and the thing is that when you have to refuel other supercars, you have to charge this. So it's basically the same, it comes to the same level.
And how much time does it take for a full charge in this car?
On a supercharger, on a fast charger, it takes an hour.
That's quick.
Yeah. So you drive 300 kilometers, stop, have coffee, have lunch, something like that, and continue driving. And the thing is that, you know, since there's no big noise, it doesn't wear you down so much. Some supercars wear you down with the noise. The noise is cool when you're driving for a short while, but when you're driving a longer period of time, it will, you know, wear you down. So this is something else. This car is basically, when we started, we knew it's gonna be something else. We knew it's gonna be different to anything else.
Yeah, absolutely.
But it turned out, you know, to be our top product. So, you know. Now if we go to the modes, if we go to vehicle and then to stats, we can see how we were driving and everything. So this is how you can see this. So this is all the data that you can see, that you can overlap, you can choose any other data that you want, you know. So there's quite a lot of these. So slip angle, what was the slip angle of the car and stuff like that.
Right guys, we're back from the test drive. It's been a seriously impressive and different test drive, because, well, as you know, the driving experience behind an Elettrica is totally different from the cars with a conventional combustion engine. And well, doing the test drive in the world's most powerful electric hypercar was just unbelievable. The acceleration, I think that my reaction when I realized that the speedometer was in miles per hour and not kilometers per hour, well, I think that says it all. I've never seen so much technology behind a car, and I think that Rimac is really stepping up the level with this car. I've been told that very close to finish the development of their new model, which is gonna be even better than this. I cannot imagine a car that is even more powerful than this. Big thanks to Rimac for inviting me for the test ride in this incredible car. And by the way guys, we shot the video in a closed road. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more. And as always, thanks for watching. Ciao!
I'm really excited to be driving a Rolls-Royce, because this is actually my first experience behind a Rolls-Royce. My friends at Love Cars have been kind enough to lend me the keys of their Rolls-Royce Don't Test car.